So I'm sitting on the porch looking at the trees. The cool summer morning is so beautiful, and the birds' song is absolutely magnificent. I think about the life I've had, and I am not regretting anything. I've lived how I've lived. I did what I've had to. But now I can just relax and enjoy myself and this great coffee. If I disappeared now, it would be okay. The moment is perfect. To want anything more would be just sheer greed. I'm just an old retiree sitting in my favorite chair on my porch. It can't get better than that. But the coffee is gone. I get up slowly, sighing. I do want another one. I like this brand. Much better than the other I drank for years. This one tastes a lot smoother. I'm glad Joyce brought some over that one time she came to visit. What a great beverage for the perfect morning. But what happened to that flower bed over there? Those poor things definitely need water. And all those weeds need to be pulled out. Let me just put down my coffee cup on this table and go to the shed and get the watering can, the gloves, and... Ah, but not in these pants. I can't do garden work in these. These pants need to be changed. So let's go in the house and find those old checkered ones. The green ones, yeah. Yeah, they're green, definitely green. Oh boy, I haven't worn them in a long time. But look at this guy. I look terrible in the hallway mirror. Maybe it's the lights in here or something. Just look at those gigantic bags under my eyes and those deep wrinkles. Do those vitamins I take work at all? Well, that's right. I haven't taken them this morning yet. Well, I have to take them if I want to look better than that old scarecrow in the mirror. Let's go to the bathroom. What? What is the remote doing on the edge of the sink? So this is why I couldn't find it yesterday. I was looking for this bad boy for hours. I mean, who put it here? This is not where it goes. I better not catch that maid leaving things around, because if she does, well, then her butt will be gone. I've been finding all kinds of things in odd places. I'd better put this remote back in the living room so I won't have to look for it again tonight. This bookshelf in the hallway is disgustingly dusty. Let me just put this remote down here for a second and get the small duster from the kitchen. I saw it on top of the fridge, I think. Where the heck is it there anyway? It should be in the closet by the stairs. What? What? Who are you? What do you want here? The creature is sitting by my kitchen table. It looks like a humanoid shadow, but has three pairs of eyes. In its mouth there are sharp teeth, kind of like shark teeth would be. And if I squint my eyes, I see sparks, kind of like stars in the darkness. That is its body? I think of him as he, but it's irrelevant given that he probably has no gender. I also might be seeing some tentacles under the table. He says he's been looking for me for years. He says he needs something from me. He seems familiar. He reminds me of the many unusual things I saw and experienced in the 60s, back when I still worked for the CIA. We were looking for aliens. We found them. We studied them. We experimented with them. Then we tortured them. We killed them, many of them, for curiosity, for science, for homeland security. I ask him if we've met before. While I think about the coffee I wanted to drink so bad, he asks, "Don't you remember?" His voice is like a thundering shout in a great hall. I tell him there were so many of them, so many different races, different types, it's impossible to remember all of them. It's nothing personal. He does seem familiar, though. He says it doesn't matter. It's not why he is here. He wants the red folder. The red folder doesn't exist anymore, I tell him. Why would he want it anyway? It only contained ideas and theories for experimental technology that we were never able to make into existing technology anyway. Oh, and I wanted to change these pants, too. He says he and his race wants the dimension breaker. The dimension breaker would be a gate between different dimensions, but it would not only provide traveling between those parallel worlds, but would also the user to change the... the frequency and wavelength of the energy and the movements of the atoms of one dimension, ultimately being able to change it, destroy it completely, or even to create new worlds. He says he wants to destroy the human race. Erase even the memory of it, with a possibility for it to reappear again, for the things we've done to him and his people. I can't say I blame him. It sounds like a reasonable reaction for the things we probably did do to them. I tell him that luckily, for us humans, the Red Folder was destroyed in the 60s and no copies were ever made. So sorry, but it's not going to work, pal. And let's not forget about taking those vitamins. He leans forward and gives me a little notepaper which has the words, "Get the Red Folder," written on it. I laugh and say, "What is this nonsense? Just because you wrote it on a piece of paper, it doesn't mean I will or can do it. But hey, good job on imitating my handwriting." But when I look up, he is gone, like he's never been there. Still smiling, I start walking to the trash can to throw away the note. Crazy alien, I say to myself. This whole thing was just so silly. What the hell was he thinking? The coffee. It's still nice and hot in the coffee pot. Didn't I want some? Oh, but I left the cup on the table on the porch. I better go get it. But wasn't I doing something? What is this note? Get the Red Folder. Why would I want to get the Red Folder? That thing is extremely dangerous. It should have been destroyed in the 60s. I probably should throw away this stupid piece of paper. Why did I make this note in the first place? Wait, wasn't someone here just a minute ago? The note reminds me of my mother. She had Alzheimer's. Nasty condition. We had to write her tons of notes, but she still forgot everything. But the worst thing was that she didn't even realize it. She thought everything was okay. What the heck is the small duster doing on top of the fridge? It should be in the closet next to the stairs. I have to ask that maid why she leaves things all over the place. I better put this thing back in the closet by the stairs. Ugh! I look like the mummy in this mirror. Yellow skin, scary thin face. I look like I'm 1,000 years old. Those vitamins don't seem to be working. Or is it the lighting in here? But what was I doing? Oh, I was getting the Red Folder. Good thing I have this note about it. It should be right here in the bedroom, behind the bed. But what did I actually want it for? Oh my God, these sheets are filthy. What does this maid do here anyway? Everything is dusty and dirty. Seems like she hasn't cleaned a thing for weeks. She needs to be fired immediately. But what was I doing here? Oh yeah, the folder. It's on the note. Let's just move this bed mattress a little bit. And there is the secret safe. Fingerprint. Eye scan. Voice recognition. DNA identification. The works. I haven't opened it in ages. Oh, there is the folder. But what did I want with it? This is very dangerous. Let me just sit down for a second. I am dead tired. I feel like I've been running around all morning. What is this? Get the Red Folder? Didn't I just have it? Now where did I put it? I thought I had it right on the bed next to me. Well, it's not there, and it's not in the safe. I'll look for it later. Let me have some coffee first. I'm so tired. I need to wake up. Oh, but the coffee cup is on the porch. Let's go get it quickly. What a gorgeous morning. I have to sit down for a moment to enjoy it. It would be a shame not to. So I'm sitting on the porch, looking at the trees. The cool summer morning is so beautiful, and oh so quiet. Even the birds are stunned by this beauty because there is not a single sound. I think about the life I have had, and I am not regretting anything. I've lived how I've lived, did what I had to do. Now I could just relax and enjoy myself in this great coffee. If I disappeared now, it would be okay. The moment is perfect. To want anything more would just be sheer greed. And it's so quiet. I've never experienced silence this deep.